Good morning, students. Today, I am going to discuss about compound personal pronoun. Before moving to the next step, make sure that personal pronoun is clear to you all that we discussed in the previous class. Then we come to that compound personal pronoun. When self is added to my, your, him, her, it, and selves to our, your, them, we get what are called compound personal pronoun. There are two types of compound personal pronouns. Number one is reflexive and the another one is emphatic pronoun. So, what is reflexive pronoun? It reflects the action done by the subject upon itself. It is formed by adding self for single or singular numbers or selves, S-E-L-V-E-S, for multiple or plural numbers to the personal pronoun. So, when the action done by the subject turns back upon the subject, the pronoun is called reflexive pronoun. It will become more easier to you when I give you some example. Ravi is very proud of himself. So, here that himself refers to whom? Ravi. So, this himself is reflexive pronoun used here. I complete the work myself. Myself refers to whom? I. So, here in this sentence, myself is the reflexive pronoun. Reflexive pronouns are placed at the end of a sentence. Very easy way to remember that reflexive pronoun is placed at the end of a sentence. In the previous sentence, you can see that Ravi is very proud of himself. Himself is placed at last, right? So, this is the easiest way to remember. Now comes to that emphatic pronoun. A pronoun that emphasizes the actions done by the subject is called emphatic pronoun. I'm repeating it again. Compound personal pronouns. Compound personal pronoun used for the sake of emphasis are called emphatic or emphasizing pronoun. Like reflexive pronoun, emphatic pronouns too is formed by adding self to the singular number and selves to the plural number. In a sentence, the emphatic pronoun comes just after the personal pronoun. Whereas I told you that the reflexive pronoun are placed at the end of a sentence and emphatic pronoun comes just after the personal pronoun, while the reflexive pronoun comes after the verb. To make it more clear, I'm giving you a few examples. He himself gave us this news. He is the personal pronoun here and himself is emphatic pronoun. And himself is placed immediately after the personal pronoun he. So, this is the easiest way to remember. Next one, I myself did the homework. I is personal pronoun here and myself is emphatic pronoun which is placed just after the personal pronoun I. So it's very easy to remember that reflexive pronouns are placed at the end of a sentence. Emphatic pronouns are placed immediately after the subject of the sentences. In your book, many examples are given. Just go through all these and try to understand where we use reflexive and emphatic pronoun. Till here for today. Thank you.